Olga? Leave the... my throat, maybe I might need. Another thing also. And this another one. In the pouch. That's for now. So nice. We all have today gathered here on top of this beautiful mountain to celebrate the resurrection of Christ. It's very significant for Sahaja Yogis to understand the great event of His resurrection, by which He showed that the spirit does not die. He was the Omkara, He was the Logos, and He was the Spirit. That is why He could walk on the water. And also, now we have made a film where we have shown how the Muladhara, which shows the carbon atom, as clearly, if you see from right to the left, you find a proper swastika there. And left to the right, we see Omkar. But when you see from down below upward, what you see is Alpha and Omega. That proves beyond doubt that Christ, as He said, I am the Alpha and I am the Omega, shows clearly that He was the incarnation of Shri Ganesh. It's a scientific proof we have now with us, and that's how we can tell people that it's a fact. I don't know at the time of Christ, this Alpha and Omega was known to the mathematicians, but definitely to Him when He said, I am the Alpha and the Omega. His was an incarnation, very remarkable and very important for our ascent. If He had not resurrected Himself, we could not have achieved our ascent at all. So it's a great contribution. The resurrection of Christ is evident now in your own life. What you were before and what you are today. It is such a change, such a difference, such a transformation. It is His own sacrifice on the cross and His own beautiful resurrection has created a way for all of us to get into this new transformed state. In this state is a different story for human beings and a different for Christ. Christ was Himself, was holiness or purity. So, His resurrection is nothing but just a physical happening, we can say, because He did not need transformation. He did not have to go through any cleansing. But what happened in His case was that He became resurrected from death. Symbolizes the life of human beings without spirituality is like a death. Because they do everything without any understanding about the totality, about the reality, about the absolute truth. Whatever they do ultimately takes them to their destruction. Even the religions which are established by these great incarnations are absolutely on a decline. You do not find any trace of religious life with all those people who claim that they are the ones who can represent those incarnations. If you see in a subtle way, it's very painful also that in the name of all these great incarnations, the kind of work people are doing, the activities that they take to, is something impossible because they have no fear of God. In the name of God, they are doing all these horrible things all over the world. Of course, here you can say Catholic Church has been exposed. Everywhere people are seeing all these false things have been exposed. But these false things they have used under a garb of God, spirituality and beauty. That's the best way you can hide all the cruelty, all the violence, all the ugliness. This is how they have worked it out. And it has gone into such a state that you do not find the slightest even tinge of religious life among these people. Like all the thieves of the world, all the great crooks of the world, and all the intriguers of the world has taken over. It's only because what was written in all the books, on all the scriptures, that you have to seek yourself, was never done. You have to know yourself, was never done. How many times Christ has said, know thyself? He also said that you are to be born again. So immediately they take a certificate, I am born again, and start taking advantage of that kind of a certificate. But they don't think that actually what benevolence it has given them. At the most they might have made some money, at the most they might have had some superficial powers. But it has done nothing, if you see, from innate nature. One must pity their insanity, the way they have taken to Christ's life or to anybody else's life of such a noble and a higher value system, and are doing all very low-graded things. In Sahaja Yoga now, you have transformed yourself. I would say your kundalini has done the job. But still, the difference between Christ and you is this, that you are coming from that environment, that style of life, that kind of thinking, which was all for your destruction. Everything, if you see now, is for your destruction. So when you are coming out of it, still these things hang over. Still you get affected by them. Even when you are rising higher and higher, you find suddenly you are again pushed down to some sort of a funny situation, to some sort of a degrading things. Of course, sometimes you are shocked at yourself. Sometimes you accept all that. So for a Sahaja Yogi it is very important that after coming to realization, he has to be very introspective. Instead of seeing the bad of others, he should try to see what is bad in within himself. It's very important that you have to know how far you are going towards your spirituality. Because Christ did not need this. He did not have to even introspect himself. He was something which was beyond any corruption. And for him, it was just a physical transformation in the sense that from he died and then he resurrected himself. But for us, it is very different. We are now Sahaja Yogis, but we were ordinary human beings. We had no light within us. Now the light comes within us and we see the light, then what do we become? We have to become the light itself. Christ was the light. He did not have to become. But we have to become the light. And now you have to guard on the way this light might get disturbed, might be reduced, or maybe completely extinguished. So carrying on yourself with this light, first thing you should know that if you see the light is not proper, means you are not the light. You have to become the light. When you are the light, then in that light you can easily see how your mind works, what ideas it gives, what affects your mind while you are ascending. Is this the worry or is this the responsibility that you have? Or is this from the bad habits you had, that there is an impediment in your growth as a spiritual personality? So you have to guard yourself all the time and see for yourself how you are progressing. It's a very beautiful journey, very, very beautiful journey. Yesterday I was very much happy to hear the song of the Russians who describe about the journey of Kundalini. This is true, no doubt, that you are a realized soul. Basically, you were not a realized soul. But now you are a realized soul. You are an evolved state. Now what is missing is the idea that we are absolutely all right and nothing can harm us, nothing can bring us down. If you develop such an egoistical idea, it's not going to help you at all. What you have to do is to all the time introspect yourself. That's what is meditation for. To see for yourself how you are keeping up your spiritual ascent. No one else can do it. It's your own individual work. Of course, if you go to the collective, immediately they will know what chakras you are catching. No doubt. They may not say, they may not refer it, but they will know definitely that such and such chakra is catching and this person has this problem. But they won't know themselves what they are catching. What is their problem is. So if somebody tells you that I think this chakra is catching in you, you should never, never feel bad about it. Because by keeping that chakra intact, you are ruining your own life. So what you have to do is to see that if somebody tells you that I think this chakra is there's something wrong, you should thank that person, thank what you have told me. Like a mirror, if you see in the mirror there's something wrong with your face, you can immediately correct it. In the same way, if somebody points it out to you, you have to be mature enough that you should know that it's a great blessing that such thing has been pointed out to you. Like the other day there was some quarrel between the two leaders, always. There are two leaders, always there are quarrels. There should not be. It's like two eyes never fight, two hands don't fight, two legs do not fight. But if there are two leaders, there's always a problem. You have to have always one leader, otherwise it's a big problem. So they were arguing among themselves, you see. Two leaders arguing among themselves. And they came to me. Immediately I saw one of them was absolutely caught up. I said, you put your hands towards me. When he puts his hand towards me, immediately he pushed it back. So what happened? He said, I'm getting burning sensation, mother. I said, that's it. Now do you know what's wrong with you? He says, I'm very hot tempered now, I know. I'm very egoistical, I should not have behaved like that. But at the same time, he could have felt very bad because I said it to him. But he did not, because he is a surgeon and he knows what is benevolent for him, what is good for him. He did not feel bad at all. On the contrary, he was so thankful to me that, mother, because of you I have been found out. Otherwise I was hiding it within my heart. Now, the problem with us is that we have achieved lot of development within ourselves. And we have consolidated it. Also we have a great collective force I can see in every country. We can give realizations to so many and we can really establish all these great truths in our lives. We can do it. All the time we should establish them. But there is one point on which one should not be very sure that you have absolutely reached the last truth. You have to be careful on this point very much. I have seen people who go very high in Sahaja Yoga, come up very high and suddenly they go down very low. Makes me very sad, extremely sad. The reason is that they have no faith. Faith in themselves and faith in Sahaj. This is the faith which is missing. You have to have faith in yourself and faith in Sahaj. Sahaj means there is the divine power. And this all-pervading divine power is looking after us. It is now felt also, you have felt it. It's not that only my saying is there. You have known that it is so. But even knowing that, it has not become such a faith within you. But this is the faith about Christ has talked. This is the faith with an enlightened mind, not the blind faith. And with the blind, you might make mistakes. While with the enlightened one, if you have faith, you become extremely powerful. Extremely powerful. there cannot be any problems if your faith is enlightened. So now, you see in Sahaja Yoga, many people who are very steady, who are upright, who are very valuable. They are like the people who know they are standing on the rocks. But those who are not yet so steady are the people they think they are still dwindling on some sort of a funny waters of this life. The rocks are there, standing on the rocks. And also that has come out of faith, that nothing can disturb us, that faith, nothing can trouble us. As far as Christ is concerned, naturally, I mean, He knew everything, so He was sure about it. He never bothered, He never dwindled, He never doubted. He knew that He is the Son of God, and that was the fact that He knew very well. And He never challenged it, He never doubted it, nothing. It is so. And that's why He, I say, was standing on the rocks. While the other people, even Sahaja Yogis, have to become like Christ as far as the faith is concerned. This faith is to be understood. This is an enlightened faith. Like Christ, He went into crucifixion, He went into all kinds of things, just because He knew it was just a drama, and He was doing all this just in a drama playing, and there's nothing serious, nothing is going to matter, and that He is going to resurrect Himself. He played a drama. To Him, it was nothing very serious. He saw people making fun of Him, mocking at Him. He also, in His heart, knew everything, that these people who are mocking don't know what I am. But at the same time, He was the embodiment of faith. Faith in Himself and in this all-pervading power. This never lets you down. But for that, you have to have absolute faith. Supposing I have someone on whom I have faith. Naturally, I will give him all the work. I will trust everything. I'll keep the keys with him, all the money with him. Never doubt such a person. In the same way, if you have faith, faith in yourself, faith in Sahajayoga where you are established, you'll be surprised how things will work out, how life will improve, and you will be standing on the rocks, you'll feel that way. You'll have no doubts, you'll have no problems, no diseases. So, this is such a state, only with faith. But now this faith, how do you get? The problem is how to get to this faith. There's no course about it, there's no literature about it, there's no lecture about it. But there is an awakening within you which will ask, this, what am I? This awakening, what am I? What have I achieved? See, this will question, what is it that I have achieved? What have I got out of Sahaja Yoga? All these questions will come to you. But if you have faith, not the blind, but the enlightened, which is established by many miracles in life, many things in life, small, small things you will find there have been miracles, small, small things. There have been miracles even in big things, in so many things where you never expected this will happen. So now you know very well settled that you are now very nicely in Sahajayoga. For example, it starts raining. Half of you would get worried about it, why it's raining. But they will know that there's a very beautiful roof, nothing can happen. Let it rain as much as it likes. And then you'll have faith that it is not going to rain, it's not going to drench us. In the same way, this faith within us has to be absolutely solid. And that makes you extremely strong and makes you responsible for the resurrection of thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of people. This kind of life that we have, that only by our own establishment, by our own understanding, by our own observation, that we settle into ourselves, we settle into Sahajayoga. It's something remarkable. It has happened, it is happening, and should happen to all of you. You all should have the chance to know your spirit and to know yourself. So one has to have faith in oneself. I've seen some Sahajayoginis always come and say, Mother, I'm no good, I'm useless, I'm doing no work, I'm absolutely a lazy lump or whatever it is. It's all right. You think that way? Ask for it. What do you want? Even if you don't ask, it will work out. Even if you don't ask. Even you just think about it, it will work out. Even if you pay attention, it will work out. Because this all-pervading power is the only real power, that all the rest of the powers are useless. And is so very efficient, so compassionate, that in the split of the second, it can work out things. The other day, we had somebody from Australia, and he was deceived by someone and made him buy a land and a house at a very exorbitant price, for which he had no money. And this fellow said, doesn't matter, even if you don't have money, they will not say anything to you. He believed him, had wrong faith, I should say. And then he said, all right, he paid all the money that he had just to deserve it. Somebody went there. There was a puja, so many were there. So many pujas, see. And things happened, and so many people came and saw and this. But this fellow was so upset, he could not understand why it has happened to me that I am placed into such a difficult situation. And he was deceived and he was, absolutely flabbergasted. He had no idea as to how he will get out of this mess. He had put in all his money there. Everything was involved, and if he doesn't pay that money, he would have been in jail. I just wrote to him, have faith in yourself, that's all, have faith. And what a miraculous thing happened, that somebody else offered a much higher price for that. And that fellow said, of course I'll pay whatever you have promised, I'll pay you back, and I'll pay you all the more that I want to pay. It's something unbelievable. So many went there, so many wanted to solve the problem, did this, met the fellow and told them that he cannot pay. Nothing worked out, nothing. Only his faith. And can you imagine now, he's going to become a rich man. He was supposed to go to jail, now he's going to become a rich man. There are many miracles like that that happen. This is just a financial side of it, but I know, you know, that there are so many other miracles happening. After realization, if you do not have faith, that shows, I mean, you are a very poor personality. After realization, at least, you should take to faith. That really is something surprising, that people get their realization and everything, still they do not have faith in themselves. Those who have had, have really achieved so much. Now, the difference between us and Christ is that faith was part and parcel of his being. It was not that he had to have faith, he was faith. Now we have to have, we have to believe in ourselves. There are so many incidents I can give you, which you can also tell me, so many incidents where just the faith has helped. If you were in Romania, I think it happened, one lady came on the stage, she couldn't walk, they had to bring her on a wheelchair. And she said, "Mother, I know you can cure me. Nobody can cure me. I know you can cure me." She said it 3 times. I said, "So, you believe that I'll cure you?" "Yes." I said, "Then get up." She just got up, walked out. And then she started running all the way. And everybody started laughing. They said, "Mother, she's not a Sahajayogini." I said, "See her faith." Because when there is faith, all the deities take it up. They are challenged. They have to do it. You have shown faith in that person. As I have told you always, in Sahajayoga we trust people. We trust. One among 100 might deceive us, doesn't matter, we trust. That faith you put in that person works in his mind also, that they have put so much faith in me. But what about deities? You show faith in them, they work. Immediately they work out. Like Guido told me that, "Mother, they said there will be heavy rains for these 2 days. I said, "All right, don't worry. Where is the rain?" It disappeared. You can control anything if your faith is under control. And when we talk of faith, you know, is the challenge to this all-pervading power, which organizes, which knows everything, which is so intelligent, efficient, above all it loves you. And then you show faith. The resurrection in Sahajayoga is that your faith is solid. This you have to achieve. Solid faith. They don't feel then bad, supposing I may not meet them, supposing I may say, "All right, comes this time I may not be with them." Nothing matters. You see, whether mother meets us or not, whether this thing happens or not, everything is for our good, for our benevolence. Supposing you are lost on the way, know that it has to be that way. If you have to look at the life of Christ, he was to be crucified. He had to carry the cross. He had to do all these things. It's all right. Whatever. He's fated. I'll do it. He never grumbled. He never grudged. He didn't want anybody to share his problems. But this faith in him gave him such a tremendous powers He could have done anything. He could have killed all these people who were trying to persecute him easily. What's the just one glance could have killed them. But no. He knew he had to go through all that, he went through it. Ultimately, he is the one who is victorious. He is the one who won everything. In the same way, a Sahaja Yogi has to look at one's own life. It's a very precious life. It's very precious. In this world, these days, how many there are Sahaja Yogis? In the evolutionary process, how many will become Sahaja Yogis, I can't say. And once look at the world, then you start feeling that most of it is going to be destroyed or finished. Most of the people are not going to be there. Not that we are not available, but because they are not fated to come to Sahaja. They are not meant to come to Sahaja. So you are so fortunate that you have got your realization, your resurrection. But now have faith in that resurrection of yours, in your resurrection that is your being now. And with that you will know how precious you are for the whole world. And that what you have to do is not to think of material gains, physical gains or some emotional gains, but spiritual gains. What have we done for spirituality, our own and of others? This is the only thing you have to think about, and you will be amazed. Everything is organized, everything works out, everything in its own time shows its own results. Now I am sure at least 80% of you believe in what I am saying. Maybe say 90%. But there could be about 10% who still think that, all right, mother says so, but then why it happened, why that happened? Like the other day I had a journalist, very well known person, he said, I can't believe in God. I said, why? Because how can there be such miseries in this world? How can there be a blind child? How can this and how can? Then he started giving me instances. All right, now I said, have you told me everything? Yes. I said, now, supposing we say that you are sitting in the realm of Congress government or your Andriyati government or whatever you call it. So the situation is explainable. You have not yet gone into the realm of God. If you go to that state and if you achieve it and if you settle down, then tell me, have you any problems? None. I said, why do you see to the negative side? Now if you say that there is a way out and that there is a solution and that a time can come when in this race of Sahaja Yogis there will be no diseases, no troubles, nothing, no problems. So why not see this? Why do you want to see one boy who is blind? But why don't you see that the blind become all right? So this kind of negative attitude also Sahaja Yogis can have. I've seen them, somebody is sick, they'll say, mother, he's sick, I must bring him to you, you must see them. There's no need at all. So you can cure. Your faith can cure. You know about somebody whose uncle was sick, who was not a Sahaja Yogi. He went down there to see him. And his wife said that, you are capable of praying to mother, why don't you tell her to get my husband all right? He was a cancer patient, deathbed. He said, all right, he just bowed down and he prayed, mother, please cure my uncle. Third day he was out of hospital and now he is roaming about all over the world. Though he is not a Sahaja Yogi, still it has worked, because now a Sahaja Yogi is saying that, the deities have to work it out. Though he's not a Sahajayoga, it doesn't matter. It's the deities who stood by it. And this, one has to believe in oneself fully, that if these powers are with us, why not we use it? Why not we develop that complete faith that we are now Sahajayogis, we are in the kingdom of God, and that this power is going to look after us. Then we'll have no choices. We'll have no hesitation. We'll not bother. If you have to go to stay to Singapore, or you have to go to Africa, or go anywhere, so what? We are still in the kingdom of God. Wherever we go, it's perfectly all right. And no worry of any kind. We are slaves of so many things, of our watches, we are slaves of conditionings, things like that. Everything drops out. Doesn't matter. What does it matter? Nothing is important. As long as you are with yourself, everything is all right. Like people tell me, Mother, you travel so much, how do you do it? I said, I never travel. As I am sitting here in the chair, I am sitting there in the chair, that's all. Only the seat is changed. I never think I am traveling. Nicely sitting down, settled in my seat, I am all right, so I am not tired. So when you have complete faith in yourself, then you don't bother. Many people will find out whether I go there will be a bathroom or not, or there will be a place to sleep or not. Nothing. You are looking for the comfort of your spirit. If you get well and good, otherwise you can sleep anywhere. Nothing can bind you. Nothing can pull you down. No habit can come back on you. Because faith will purify you completely. It will enlighten you, it will nourish you. This faith is not something that can be put into your heads or can be put into your hearts. Cannot be. It's a state which you have to achieve and which you can achieve through Sahajayoga. That's how our resurrection would be complete, would be established, would be effective, and for the whole world will be a model. May God bless you. They're just the children, if there's so many children. Today is the day of Christ, so we should have children in any case to wash my feet. Can you put it there, or I'll have to move it?
asti trayatmaka tvam yogino jayanti nityam tvam brahma tvam vishnu tvam rudra tvam indra tvam agni tvam vayu tvam surya tvam chandrama tvam brahma purbhuva swaram
Sanskrit 11.
Ah. 14 married ladies, possibly those who have not been before. 14 donne sposate, possibilmente che non siano mai state prima ai piedi di Shri Mataji.
1967. O Sanskrit 14.
Namo 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 Namo.
the leaders for the arti.
Patrizia from Perugia. Patrizia from Perugia.
Караван отправляется в Индию, сотни верблюдов под нами ревут. Горы иранские, горы афганские и пакистанские мимо плывут. О,
Bye.
ladies bring the prasad on the stage so that Shri Mataji can vibrate it all at once. Per cortesia, le ragazze possono portare il prasad sul palco in modo che Shri Mataji possa vibrare tutto. Non c'è bisogno di passare una per una davanti a Shri Mataji. Hindi 31. Chalata musafir moliare pinjare vali muni aha. Chalata musafir moliare pinjare vali muni. Chalata musafir moliare pinjare. Urbeti Muldara Dawaria Maji Urbeti Muldara Dawaria Maji Ganesh ke sabra saleli are binjare wali muniya
sabra saleli are binjare wali muniya
sabra saleli are binjare wali muniya sangit ke sabra saleli are binjare wali muniya Urbeti, oh, urbeti, deco, urbeti, swadistan da varia magi, urbeti, swadistan da varia magi, ali che sapera saleli a re vincere vali munia,
ali che sapera
Urbeti nabi ke dawaria maji.
Urbeti nabi ke dawaria maji.
Lakshmi ke sapera saleli are pinjare wali muniya.
Tari ke sapera saleli are pinjare wali muniya.
Vishnu ke sapera saleli are pinjare wali muniya.
Vishnu ke sapera
Musafir moliare pinjare wali muniya
Mataji, 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 Mata Bye. Shri Mataji. So, Shri Mataji, what is taking place now is just an egoistic self-indulgence of your children who have the illusions that they offer you something and please, in your kind Maya, accept this token of our love. Thank you, Shri Mataji.
This is a present from Bulgaria.
We have an happy occasion. We would like to announce the imminent marriage of Carol and Finn. Siddharth for the young boy. Anya. Divya will be the name for Anya from Poland. Minakshi. Vimala. Mahesha. Raja Lakshmi for Mariangela. Vinayaka for Bastian. Vandana, Vandana. Shweta, Shweta Devi. Varada, the giver of blessings. Parvati. Niranjan, Niranjan. Adia. Madhavi. Antonio.
Please.
Radhika. Anand. Very, very important announcement for children. Shri Mataji has brought some Easter eggs for all of them. But they will have to collect it later. After Shri Mataji will be gone. Parish. The one who is gone beyond. Janaki for the little Brazilian girl. We would like to know which country has given some gold to S. Govind in India to prepare a golden crown. Is there any country here who has given gold to S. Govind to prepare a crown? Even in the past. Last year or 2 years back. Sarvesh for the boy. Aradhana. Aradhana.